Mr. Cotter, can we talk about bisexuality? I think we should. Hi, everybody. It's Rob coming back and appreciating Michelle giving me the opportunity to speak on this topic, the one that Maya suggested, that we address the issue of bisexuality. And her first question to the masses is, do you know a bisexual? If you do not know, if you have not previous to this moment, you do now. I am Rob, I am bisexual, 100% bisexual, meaning simply this. What is a bisexual? A bisexual is an individual who is attracted to members of both sexes. I don't know how we can make that any more blunt or plain than that. But what we need to do is we need to address how this issue has and is affecting me. A little bit of a previous on me, the previous info myself is that I was a guest blogger several months ago on the issue of how do you treat your child who is in the dating age, and if they have a same-sex partner, do you treat their dating habits differently than you would treat your child who was dating a person of the opposite gender? So I'm back now with another piece of information from my own experience. As far as I'm concerned, my direct response is that I have always been bi. I have always been attracted to guys and girls, but the social constructs that we have had have prevented me from displaying and admitting to the sexual attraction to men, because that was the era in which I grew up in, the 1970s. I do know the time that I first really was crushing on a guy. It was a jock. It was in seventh grade, the same year that I happened to have a girlfriend. Not the best relationship, because she wound up stealing my bike. That's another story. And it has been like that ever since. I can see guys that I'm attracted to. I can see girls that I'm attracted to. In high school, I had a relationship with a guy who I fell in love with. Our life courses took us on a different aims, but we still keep in contact. We still have a deep abiding love for each other. If circumstances were different, we could possibly be together, I really think. The marriage that I had lasted 20 years. In both of these situations, I was committed to the individual that I was with at the time, but that did not erase that part of the cortex of me that is attracted to people of both sexes. I mentioned the boyfriend that I had in high school. At that time, I was a member of the photography team for our publications, and as such, I got to go to a lot of events, sporting clubs, what have you, and I had a nice telephoto lens. And particularly in sporting events, I could scan the teams, scan the stands, scan the cheerleaders, scan the jocks, and it's always been that desire. Now, I believe we differ from the LG compatriots that we have, is that we do, or at least I do, make a choice on who I am going to develop a relationship, or who I wish to pursue a relationship. So those right ringers out there who say that being gay is a choice might have modicum of validity to that statement, but in reality, just because I find a personality and a physicality that I like doesn't mean that I negate the attraction that I have for the other sex. I'm going to change the light here a little bit. Change me. Here we come. Well, it's not going to do us. Okay, light is dying. I'm sorry about that. Anyhow, so talking about that once again, that just because I have decided to get into a specific relationship does not negate the attractions that I've had or the past relationships that I've had with a member of the opposite sex or a member of the same sex. My attractions, my desires, my longings, still, I'm going to try, there we go, hello people, are still very much same-sex oriented, always have been and always will be. You know, I think it's kind of comical. We have the show The Bachelor and The Bachelorette, and you've got the bachelor meeting the contestants that are going to come in. You got the bachelorette are going to meet the contestants, and they're all kind of, anticipatory, hubble, 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 look at these great hung studs, look at these bodacious babes and all of that. I'd like to see a bachelor, bachelorette that has a mixed bag for the bisexuals out there and see how that would really, really pan out. Because I can envision that that would be a relative and real experience for myself. Do we get discrimination from members of our LGBT members of our group? Yeah. A recent job that I had a friend, a co-worker, who was 100% gay. And we would discuss these issues from time to time. And he was just saying, and he would say that, well, this is something that I need to come to grips with because I can't really appreciate women and men equally. Hello, I was married for 20 years. I had 3 children with this woman. We had sexual relations. I had a friend, boyfriend in high school. We had sexual relations, and in each of those situations, I felt a deep love, a deep personal commitment to that particular individual. I don't understand why people don't get it. It seems to me that it should be quite obvious, but hey, life is what it is. So that's where I'm at. If you got any questions, put them below. I'll answer them. I'm just trying to keep this under 9 minutes if possible. I've appreciated the opportunity to come back. I need to scratch my beard and trim that down a little bit. But Out Late, you're great. Michelle, thank you again. And maybe Mr. Cotter has something special for you after school for allowing me to do this presentation. No? But you did like the show, right? Okay. Hope to come back again, guys. Loved it very much. Have a fine, wonderful, glorious, super fantastic day. Oh, and Jim from Ohio, do you think we're ever going to get our butts frozen off of the floors that we've had because of this winter in the North Great Lakes region? I mean, really, dude, this is painful, right? Goodbye, everybody.